There's two times the door to the subconscious mind opens up. I mean, when we wake up in the morning mm-hmm. and we go to bed at night.
Right.
Why?
In that crossover place.
Because your brain goes yeah. from deep delta brainwaves to theta brainwaves mm-hmm. to alpha brainwaves to beta brainwaves. And when you go to bed at night, it goes from beta to alpha to theta to delta. And if you can't get there, you're stuck in high beta. It's because you're driving the sports car in first gear, right? So people do whatever they can to get down there. So the brain chemistry works in accordance with this. So when you wake up in the morning and the receptors in the back of your eye pick up light, the moment that happens, your optic nerve sends a signal to the pineal gland, and the pineal gland starts making serotonin. And serotonin is the daytime neurotransmitter. In other words, serotonin gets you up and going. It gets your brain turned on. The moment it starts getting dark at night and your eye is no longer picking up visible light, the mechanism starts to change. And now, because there's less light, the optic nerve sends a signal to the pineal gland. The pineal gland takes serotonin and starts carving off a couple methyl groups and turns it into melatonin. And melatonin is the nighttime neurotransmitter. So Sarah gets you up in the morning and Mel puts you to bed at night. Now, when serotonin increases, your brainwave patterns go into beta. That's because you're going to pay attention more to the outer world. When you're in meditation and you close your eyes and you eliminate light and it's dark in the room and you play music in the background, you put earplugs in, you're getting less sensory data coming mm-hmm. in from your environment, so the neocortex is not so preoccupied with trying to create meaning between the outer world and the inner world. You're forgetting about the outer world, and the inner world is where you're cultivating something. So then, when you close your eyes and do your meditation, then your brain waves move into melatonin. But if you're waking up in the morning, and you're waking up at 5 in the morning, guess what? Your brain waves will probably be in theta or alpha. That's, you're in your subconscious. You're
right.
Past the beta thinking, right? We go to bed at night, I have friends that are artists and playwrights and musicians. They stay up till 2 in the morning. They love that 11 o'clock till 2 in the morning. They're in nighttime. They're in alpha. They got all these creative ideas.
Mm-hmm.
There's, you know, me, I'm a morning person. I wake up. I'm up at 4:30 or 5 in the morning. It's my time to create. I set aside a certain amount of time. That's my time. Because the rest of the day I'm serving. So I like to get myself right in the morning, right? So doing that then begins to alter brainwave patterns. Now, if you move from beta to alpha, there'll come an amazing moment where if you do this right, you'll slip into theta. Now, theta is when your body is asleep, but your mind is awake.
Yes.
So think about this. If your body's asleep and you've conditioned it to be the mind through addictions or habits, the moment the body's asleep, it's no longer the mind. So there's no longer any resistance. And that's where instantaneous change takes place. Well, I think the biggest lie we've been ever told is that we're linear beings living a linear life.
Yes.
I just, the moment
couldn't
I had
more.
My first couple of these experiences, I know we are dimensional beings living a very dimensional experience of reality. And all of this indoctrination is to keep us from that, because once the game is up, you can't ever go back to being the same person. So this reality, this dimension that we live in, is called space-time. Space is eternal. There's the space is the field, and you and I experience time by moving through space. So if I'm going to go here to the door, I have to get up and walk through space, and when I walk through space, I'm going to experience time. I have an interview later on today. I know it's going to happen because I'm going to linearly walk through time, space to experience that time. So in this dimension, we could say that space is the field and time is the river. And so we move, we experience time as we move through space. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
In the inverse reality, it's actually opposite. In other words, time is everywhere. There's time goes on forever. Mm-hmm. And you experience space when you move through time. You see how I can say it another way. So if time is the field and space is the river, then all of space is enfolded in time. So when you change your speed in this dimension. If we go fast from here to the door, the faster we move, the less time it takes, right? So we can change time by moving through speed. Well, in this dimension where everything is vibration and electromagnetism, the faster your vibration is, the speed, the different levels of space you experience. So all of space is stacked on top of each other here. It's all happening in now because time is everywhere. There is no time. So mm-hmm. everything's happening in this moment. And so different levels of consciousness and different levels of energy allow us to experience these different levels of space. So the you that's in the Egyptian period and the you that's in the future is all lined up simultaneously. And when you start slipping through these dimensions, you live. And when I say live, I'm saying that it is real as this. And
yeah, okay.
You know who you are.
Yes.
And the person that you're married to, or the person that you work with, or your best friend is wearing a different face, and you understand your agreement that you negotiated in all of those other places. So you have a few of those experiences, and you start to no longer care about your checking account, the car you drive, what you look like, because you realize that you look like somebody else in another place. And some of the issues and some of the challenges that you have in this life, you're experiencing in that exact same life. And the choices you make here affect the choices that are happening there. And we could say that there's only past lives and future lives in this dimension, in space-time. In that dimension, there is no past lives. It's all happening now. I don't know how else to say it, but as you begin to change your consciousness, you can slip into different spaces, different realities, and experience aspects of yourself that are just like this wonderful kaleidoscope of possibilities.